Hello, I'm Sam Meredith, and welcome to the weekly wrap-up, where joining me to discuss the market movers from this week is David Sloan, senior economist from Forecast. So firstly, Canada's employment change data has been released today, and after posting a remarkably strong gain of 58.9 thousand in the June report, we've now seen a reduction of minus 6.4 thousand. How significant a reaction can we expect from the US dollar against the Canadian dollar?
The Canadian dollar initially strengthened on the report, even though we saw a decline of 6.4 thousand jobs. We actually saw a rise of 64.8 thousand in full-time employment. And over the last 3 months, we've seen a huge 142 thousand rise in full-time employment, three straight gains. So overall, this was quite a strong report, even though there was a small decline in employment after the rise in the previous month. However, the Canadian dollar has more than fully reversed its gains fairly quickly. There's so much else going on in the market with the focus on Greece. It was really a fairly minor boost for the Canadian dollar. The Bank of Canada will certainly be looking at the figures. The Bank of Canada meets next week and will be considering a rate cut given some of the weakness in data. This number marginally reduces the risk of a rate cut, but it's still a fairly close call, and on balance we think they probably will ease rates.
In April, the IMF projected Canada's economy to grow by 2.2% by the end of 2015. However, this week the same forecast has now been cut by 0.7 percentage points due to a slump in oil prices. What is your assessment of the Canadian economy at this stage?
I think the IMF's forecast looks reasonable. We saw a decline in the first quarter. Then we saw a decline also in April's GDP. So we've had four straight months of decline, and we're going to need some pretty strong gains in May and June to see the second quarter fully reverse the decline seen in the first quarter. So I think it looks reasonable to say that for the first half of the year, the Canadian economy probably won't grow at all. Now, that's certainly weaker than was expected at the start of the year, even given the risks from the oil price decline. Now, I think we're quite optimistic about the second half of the year. We could see Canadian economy grow close to 3%. So after a flat first half, 3% in the second half would leave the overall economy about 1.5%. But I think the risk is that 3% is quite an optimistic view on the second half. So it may be that the IMF downward revision isn't quite enough. So broadly speaking, we expect the Canadian economy to do well in the second half of the year.
And lastly, the Greek government submitted its highly anticipated economic reform plan late on Thursday evening, and the country's bailout monitoring institutions now have 48 hours to consider the proposals. Reportedly, Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras told his cabinet, "We are ready to compromise." But how optimistic are you of a resolution?
I'd say the chances of a resolution are now a little above 50% rather than a little below. Certainly the Greek government has made significant concessions. They've broken a few of the red lines they'd previously set, such as on pensions. I still think they'll be able to get this compromise they've proposed through Parliament, given support from the Conservative opposition, even if there are some defections within their own ranks. It really now seems how much is Greece prepared to accept and how much is Germany prepared to offer. I think Greece is going to want, in return for these pretty painful concessions, some significant write-down in its debt, and I think Germany still seems reluctant to do that, though others in Europe, maybe such as France, may be pushing Germany to be a bit more generous. I think Greece will probably feel that they've taken a big step, and they'll expect Germany to do the same as well. I'd say probably both sides have an interest in a compromise, and we'll probably get one, but it's still a close call, and it's still an anxious situation.
Thank you, David. Check back on Monday for the week ahead with Monica Gibson. Goodbye for now.